I apparently need to figure out my drag name.
These come from the Q&A in Brighton with Daniel Muggleton.
Who else has a question? What do you got right there?
What are your drag names?
What are our drag names? Do you have a drag name?
I got one, but I stole it off a friend. Because my favorite one I've heard is like Sharon Needles, that's my favorite. But that's a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the three people who like drag, apparently. And but no, my friend's one that I've stolen is Lena Gutter. I quite like that. All right, Lena Gutter's a winner, I should text her.
That's awesome. And I apparently need to figure out my drag name.
Is that like one of those things where... Yeah.
What? I'm in Brighton. So, yeah, okay. I'll just stay up late after the show. Someone will figure it out for me. So, I have a feeling Red will be in it.
I remember the other show that called you Steve Ginger.
Right. At one of the shows, they called me Steve Ginger. Yeah. So, I feel like my drag name would have Ginger in it, probably, as like the first name. Mm. I'd be like Ginger Snaps. I think that would be it. All right. That's a decent one?
Yeah.
Single dumbest thing about English culture, like something you both just think.
There are no lights in. There's no light switch inside the bathroom.
Oh, that's such a good one.
I hate that
so much because it's the fucking. There's no light switch in the bath. If you go to the bathroom and you're like hanging out with mates that want to prank you at all, it's very easy. You guys made it super easy to just shut the lights off on somebody in the bathroom. You're like, we do it for safety. I'm like, we have outlets that don't fuck it with. If they get wet, they don't. Do that. And you're like, no, we don't want to do that. We just want to put the outlet as far away from the bathroom as possible. And in most hotel rooms, the light switch for the bathroom is on the other side of the room, and then the one next to the bed controls the one by the door. Right. Be like, oh yeah, when was this wired? Before electricity, actually. That's why. It's been around the whole time.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like that you guys still call cigarettes fags. I don't like it, because I know what you're saying. I know that you know what you're saying, and you're like, oh, but we've got history, and it's like, fuck off, you homophobes. Right? Just change it. Because I got a store around the corner of me called Fags and Booze, and I'm like, that is not what happens in the store, right? That's not the situation.
What's the weirdest chat line you've had on Tinder?
The weirdest chat up line I've had on Tinder.
I one that like I stole from my friend, but like I thought it was really funny, and then people on Tinder did not think it was funny.
Yeah.
So I abandoned it quite quickly. But like as my friend said this, I thought it was like such a good chat up line. It was like if I had to murder you, I'd strangle you.
What?
Yeah. Yeah. It's a good line. It's a good line. It's intimate. You know, it's intimate. It's personal.
And you find out if she likes being choked really quickly.
Yeah. But no, apparently it didn't work for me. I don't know if it worked for him. I think I got my hands, you know. I got I don't have thick enough hands.
Yeah, they're like, I didn't swipe on you for the thick enough hands.
How dare you?
I once had someone on me, they opened with saying, do you make a lot of money as a comedian? And I replied, enough to not have to date you. And then,
be reincarnated as any animal but with your own brain, what would you be?
Reincarnated of any animal.
But with the brain though, so you got like the self-awareness to be like, I'm a fucking worm.
Could I just be me again? Because I'm used to that.
Oh, that's such a...
No, oh I'm sorry, think through your question next time. I'm doing this with my own brain, so...
I didn't like that answer at all.
You didn't like
that? That wasn't
you didn't like it. I would be a cop-out. So, any animal at all? That's a really tough
one. What about like a shark? I wouldn't mind being a shark.
A shark?
Yeah.
I can't swim very well, but I have a good workout. So.
You could make up for that. And
perfect.
You could just attack humans who seem like they're dicks. That's just like,
not very different than now.
It's just like, look at that guy. His board shorts are the same as the flag of his country. I'm gonna fucking eat him. Right? I'm gonna get him. I'm gonna get him up.
You make a wonderful case for being a shark, by the way.
As an Australian, it's part of our education system.
Yeah.
But sir, why are there white people in Australia? Next shark-related question. Let's go on to that.
Thanks for subscribing to me on YouTube and liking my page on Facebook. If you haven't yet, go do that. Also, check out the Patreon. There's all kinds of new rewards. Not only do you get to watch videos before everybody else, but I'm also posting entire shows there. Some of them from years ago, There's also fun t-shirts and lots of other stuff. Do you want to find out when I'm performing near you? If you have an American cell phone, text the word Steve to 484848. If you're in Canada, text Steve to 393939. And if you live somewhere else, let me know what a good local texting service is. If you want to find out where else I'm performing, go to my website, stevehofstetter.com. I'll be hitting almost 200 cities this year. If your city isn't listed yet, stay tuned. And meanwhile, bug your local venues to have me in. That stuff helps. Thanks for watching.